the Land Rover is no more. It's about to become a Slam Rover. Today, we need to work out how low we can go.
The basic principle of slamming the Land Rover is take the axle on the wheels up and bring the chassis and the body down. Do those two things, that thing's riding low. We're gonna have to move this suspension hanging point right up into the chassis. That means this bracket's gonna need cutting off. What we're actually doing is moving the springs up into the chassis. That point's gonna have to come up somewhere into the chassis there. Loads of cutting, and if we cut things out, we've got to strengthen it all up. Not easy.
To make it a proper hot rod, we want to give it a rake stance. That means the front has got to be lower than the back. Problem is, we can't lose enough height simply by moving the springs. I was thinking about doing something like this. A completely new custom axle. It removes the four-wheel drive, takes away the diff, and this custom axle will bring the wheels up.
I'm starting to wonder if Jimmy's bitten off more than he can chew slamming this Land Rover.
Rebuilding our Land Rover was one of the most pleasurable jobs I think I've ever done in the workshop.
Yeah.
We've got some really beautiful bonnet straps made out of these really gorgeous belts. They're really kind of arty looking. All those little elements together just tie this whole thing in to be a really great build. Trap look that it might have had before is gone. People don't do things like this with Land Rovers, you know, this is a proper goblin thing.
We should be proud of this one, guys. This is authentic Land Rover and it is slammed to death. This vehicle, it's special.
In Jimmy's eyes, this thing's like a China doll. He just loves this thing to bits.
It's got a good look, man.
But we've got to sell this thing.
Ant's doubtful, but I've got a plan to show off our creation at a custom car venue in London tomorrow night. Then we'll see who's right about the Slam Land Rover.
We've come to this incredible location because I'm taking some pictures of the Land Rover to post all over social media. I want them to see these pictures, share it, and then come along tonight and see what we're all about. And hopefully, we're going to get a buyer. Looks amazing. With the light bouncing off everything, you see all the rivets, you see all the details, it just kind of enhances everything that we've done to it.
What began as a stock 50-year-old mud-plugging Land Rover has become a slammed rover. A one-of-a-kind custom car, and every detail, from the aircraft-inspired seats to the beautifully finished exhaust pipe, is built with goblin style.
Tell you what, I never thought I'd say this, but our little farm truck looks really good on the street.
Was that your way of saying you like it?
Yeah, I do. I think it's cool.
It does look wicked. This is a completely unique vehicle. The bespoke details, its stance. It's fairly mind-blowing, guys.
Should we get it out of here before someone comes along and spray paints this thing?
People are just like, what am I seeing? What am I seeing? I'm loving the stance. We're looking down at the road.
Yeah.
I'm sat really comfortably.
Yeah, no, we got it just right.
I can't believe the ride because I thought taking all that suspension away, old Land Rover would actually have better suspension, but it feels the same to me.
It's actually really nice. I think it's a little bit better.
It's more kind of purposeful.
Yeah. The engine sounds good though. It's just idling along, just going, and what?
That's got a rich exhaust, though, just a nice burble.
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
People are liking it.
People are loving it.
OK, here we go, bumps. Nice and steady.
This is a little bit scary. Oh, it's OK.
That's all right.
I didn't mind those. Just driven the Land Rover around East London, a now we've come to the venue where there's loads of people, it's really buzzing. It is the perfect place for this build to be revealed. Hello, nice to meet you.
Hi, Carl, Jimmy.
There is an absolute ton of custom car fans here and they're all pouring over the Land Rover, taking photographs and chatting.
This is a genuine Land Rover sales.
It sounds good too. Yeah.
There's enough interest in it. Hopefully people are out there sharing it on their social media and someone will bite.
So that is a very early drawing of what we wanted to do.
Jimmy's got a new friend.
No, the grill is totally standard, the original, not Tash.
There's this guy called Howard and he seems really keen on the Land Rover.
He needs to sell that car.
We've spent 16.5 grand on the Slam Rover, so we need to sell it for around 23 grand to bag the 40% profit we hope for. But I'm going in for a little more.
Are you going to make me an offer of it?
No.
I tried to put the hard sell on him, but he wasn't having it, so it's time to bring out the ace in the hole. The old test drive.
Do you know the streets around here, don't you, Howard?
I do.
I think it's a brilliant idea taking it out for a test drive, because the guy clearly loved the car.
It's a lovely driving experience, and I think that will be what convinces him.
Well, that was fantastic, I've got to say.
Enjoy that?
I really did. I love the way it looks. I adore the way it sounds. I'm falling in love, I've got to say.
Are you going to make me an offer for it?
You're thinking of 28.
Thinking of 28 is the number. 26, and you bring me some more work.
Agreed.
Good man.
Fantastic.
You just bought yourself a Slam Land Rover.
Nice, superb. Absolutely beautiful thing.
I've just sold that Land Rover for £26,000.
Dude.
Well done, mate.
Completely.
Wow. Probably now.
That's a massive amount of money and a massive profit.
Right, guys, let's party.
Yeah.